see some of the top seeds have gone by the wayside in the women's doubles.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome from China, here are Li Jingping and Luo Jumin.
So Chinese pair out first. Probably would say they'll start favourites. So, seventh seeds on their way. One it is on the head-to-head to Lee and Law. In fact, all three meetings have gone to three games. That last one, see there, China Open, 25-23 in the third. So let's give you some details about the four players who are about to watch in this women's doubles semi-final, starting with the Chinese pair, Li Yijing, 22 years of age. They lost to the Ibsard sisters, actually, in the final of the Thai Masters last month, this pair, and it was a real tough defeat to take. They lost 27-25 in the third in Bangkok. Her partner is Luo Xumin. Lost in the last 16 of the first two events of this year in India and then Malaysia. But as I say, they were excellent in Bangkok. Certainly came in here as one of the favoured pairs. Haven't dropped a game so far. Look at that destruction of Becker and Marburger in 18 minutes in the first round. Other two matches didn't take that much longer. And on the other side of the net, Xu Yaqing, Lin Wangqing of Chinese Taipei. 32 now, Xu Yaqing. Has been ranked at 17. That was with Wu Tianzhong, as you see there. Started playing at just 10 years of age, joined the national team at 18. And Lin Wangqing, who's 3 years younger than her partner, have won four minor titles as a pair, including a couple in Saipan last year. Been a bit tougher for them, as you can see there. A couple of three-game battles. As I say, hard to call a winner here. Winner out of Switzerland. It's in the chair. And the ever-smiling Manfred Schrum of Hong Kong, China, is the service judge.
ladies and gentlemen. On my right, Li Jing and Luo Xiaomin, China. And on my left, Su Yaqing and Lin Wanqing, Chinese Taipei. Lin Wanqing to serve to Li Jing. Love all. Play.
Just have a feeling this might be something of a cagey tactical type of match. Chinese pair be most people's favourites, but I'm sure it's going to be as straightforward as that. That's chance.
2-1.
She knows she should have made that. Mid court and midway up the net. Error of judgment there by Lee. Is that dropped comfortably in? The racket, and that was well done. Really well negotiated by Law. Smooth exchange of racket, but in the end, didn't help. It's gone long. Surprising out with that. They've been really sharp so far, Shu and Lin. Just get the feeling they're frustrating the Chinese pair a little bit. Just about everything's coming back. Lengthy exchanges, and those two would rather get things done, I think, in shorter order. So from 6-3, back on terms.
Six.
Law. Errors starting to creep into Shu and Lin's game. Well, the serve was called short. Thought about a challenge. Decided against it, probably very wisely. Well, that was a little weak.
11-8.
Truth to tell from Xu Yaqing. They're 3 points down, the Chinese Taipei pair, at the mid-game break. And that actually represents a decent comeback. Beautifully fashioned that down the line. There was a yawning gap, but it still had to be exploited.
9-11.
A little fortunate, to say the least, but she'll take it. Li Yiqing. Say you make your own luck, and I think over time that's probably true. Doesn't stop it being very annoying from the opponent's point of view. And again. Well, someone up there likes them so far this afternoon.
Thank you.
summarily dismissed from her presence.
15-11. Service over, 12-15.
Well, that's 16, three in about the 12. Last, I don't know, 7 or 8 points. What on earth must Shu and Lim be thinking? Someone does not like us. I mean, that absolutely thundered into the tape. More often than not, they fall back. That didn't. Oh, fabulous angle, that. Probably the best shot she's played.
13-16.
Great disguise on it. Laura Shu Min completely bamboozled by it. Longest rally of the match. Thought we might be in for quite a few lengthy exchanges. I still think we might be. The back foot the whole way through that rally, weren't they, Shu and Lin? The Chinese pair just a couple of points away now from taking
14.
This opening game.
Thank you.
Well, at 19-14, it looked almost 19. A formality. Now it's kind of back in the melting pot a little bit here. Mentioned all three previous matches between these pairs have gone the distance, three games. Shu and Lin not out of this opener yet. Well, that's one of the worst possible times for that to happen. It's never a good time. But that will be so frustrating. Fight back. Put themselves back in with a chance, but the serve was too high. Three game points for the Chinese pair. And they take it, 21-17. Not without the odd alarm, especially towards the end. But the number six seeds lead by a game to none.
Second game, love all, play.
Well, excellent rally to start the second game.
One love.
I think Shu and Lin, their coach at the mid-game break, would have said, look, yeah, we lost the first game, but how many net calls did they have? We made a few errors as well. Could have gone either way. Still think they are going to have a say here.
So, 2-1.
I didn't quite know there, Lee, whether to leave that or play it. In the end, it was a bit of a token gesture to wave a racket at it.
Show up. 3-4.
So often, so effective, strike down the middle.
4-5.
I think from Shu and Lin's point of view, we need to cut out those kind of errors. So made a good start of his second game, just got off the board a little bit here. And Lee and Law do not need a lot of encouragement.
Very quickly.
quickly in for the kill there. 6-8. It's been a bizarre match in the sense that both pairs are kind of scored in clusters.
7-8.
Never quite know who's on top. So again, 8-5 down, now 8-all. That must be so frustrating. Worked so hard, Lin Wenqing, to get her and her partner back level and then just give their opponents a point with a service error like that. Went with the flicker. And we're now wishing that she had.
Nine.
Number of points that Chinese Taipei pair have frittered away with service errors. Might come back to bite them. So a 2-point lead for the Chinese pair at the mid-game break. Total breakdown in communication. Yours, no mine, yours.
11.
Sorry. wide.
One of those rallies when no one could really create an opening. 87 shots, but very, very few penetrative. Big point, though, that for Xu and Lin. If they'd gone 14-10 down, you would have begun to fear the worst for them. Nicely done.
Just keep on kind of snapping at their heels, don't they, Xu and Lin? Certainly no one can begrudge them the odd net cord. They've been on the wrong end of at least three that I can remember. That's an absolutely exquisite angle. 17-12. Well, deathly hush, but that was an excellent shot. It really was. Well, they were kind of hanging on throughout that rally, Chu and Lin. Just always felt it was a question of when rather than if Lee or Law would pull the trigger. It was Law that time that did. And they're 3 points away from a place in the final here. Just when you think it's going to be done and dusted, it's just a slight change in the momentum. Massive point coming up now. That could be absolutely pivotal from Lo Xiumin. Seems like every time Xu and Lin get in range, Lee and Law shut the door on them. Another chance here to get to within a point for the Chinese Taipei pair. It was called in, in fact unsighted. So I don't think it's going to count as a challenge. I think the line judge said unsighted. It certainly looked long from that angle. Long way beyond the back line. So they are within a point.
18-19.
Can they get themselves on terms here? The answer is no, and here are two match point opportunities.
20 match point, 18.
For Lee and Law. That'll do. Just wide. And they take it 21-18. It's a straight game victory for Li Yijing and Lo Xiumin. 48 minutes on court. It was a real battle at times. Got a bit nervy at the end. But that final point, the error came from their opponents. They were very glad to see it. For sure. 21-17, 21-18. So we'll see them tomorrow. Li
Australian Law, who win 21-17, 21-18. As you see there, 48 minutes, the official match time.
Coming up next, it's our second men's singles semi-final. Jeon Hyuk-jin of Korea against Christo Popov, the young Frenchman. That's next. Welcome back to the 2024 German Open, part of the HSBC BWF World Tour. And we've moved on to our next match, which is a men's singles between Jeon Hyuk-jin of Korea and Christo Popov of France, the number 8 seed. We'll see that other semi-final, by the